What's up, Video City? It's your girl, Bree, back with the latest show on Roku TV. I got a brand new countdown for y'all this week, so let's get straight into it. I have Young LA featuring Young Dro and T.I. with their hot new single, Ain't I. Video City, take it away.
Money serving everybody. Ain't we up in Magic City throwing up the private? Ain't me until taking off like a rocket. Ain't my money long. Ain't I still putting on.
In the trunk, I'll make you do the Macarena. Pull up to the floor, yeah, motherfucker, ain't I? All the black cool, I can buy it, between K9. Remix, Young LA and T.I., this a banger. Throw you on that thing, you don't hear me trick, ain't I? Big road rushes, and I got them nauseous. We be in Ferraris, the cars with the horses. Ain't I on the pill, ride down deal. Ice 30 below, minus the wind chill. Ain't I packing chrome?
Fresh as I could be, made it through my situation. Ain't I blessed as I could be? Ain't I laughing at these haters trying to take a shot at me? They don't know which way to go. I make it easy, follow me. Honestly, ain't I insane? I think that's the way I gotta be. Ain't I so super fly? Boy, ain't nobody hiding me. Ain't T.I. all on TV when he wake up and go to sleep? Everywhere they notice me. Ain't for yourself, just go and see. My community, I'm serving, though they hope I don't succeed. Hear me speak, they so intrigued. Ain't he snitching? No, indeed. You come with that common flow, your show I have to commandeer. Since I see you can't take over, I'll just have to volunteer. Hey, ain't I your superior? Listen here, bro, you not a peer. I'm so zone one, so it ain't funny. Twice the G that I appear. Rep bank here so loud and clear. Gon' be gone for about a year. So paper trail, you gotta hear. But ain't that ain't I out of here? Hey.
Video City, that was Young LA's song. We have another hot single by him. We have Futuristic Love featuring Rico Barrina, all the way from Atlanta. Video City, take it away.
18, long hair with the baby face. Like baby face, she got a whip appeal. She ain't nothing but a stallion, it's the little me. Can you picture that? I tried to paint it clear. Space takes a spot to take us out of here. Swear this with flavor, don't you like my swag?
City, let's all sing along to this one. We have a lyric video by Gabrielle Stewart all the way from Michigan with her hot new single Seven Seasons. Video City, take it away.
Try my best to stay away.
Montez back again for a second week. We have his hot new single, Red Pill. Video City, take it away.
What the hell?
This is your last chance. After this, there is no turning back. You take the blue pill, the story ends. You wake up in your bed and believe whatever you want to believe. You take the red pill, you stay in Wonderland, and I show you how deep the rabbit hole goes. Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
This is your last chance, there is no turning back. Once you get red pills, you'll start learning that what you thought to be the truth is not actual fact. There's a battle for your mind while your body's being attacked. Chemtrails slap us from the sky, dropping heavy metal, sea spraying Frisco, hosed by Navy vessels, Project Heart, large energy transfers to the ionosphere. Operation Popeye Cloud seeding Vietnam's atmosphere. Watch the fog of war, Gulf of Tonkin attack, never happened. Iraqi WMD, something George Bush clearly imagined. 9/11 and Building 7, both should be examined. Anthrax scare, false flag ops have greatly expanded. Military enacted Oklahoma City bombings, antidepressants, drug shooters remain playing alarm in Tuskegee syphilis trials and pouring down experiments, autism rate denials, vaccines on terrible regimens. Take the red pill away from blissful ignorance, your third eye opens, you will see the difference. Take the red pill and shatter the illusion, when your mind is enlightened, we will start the revolution.
All right, Video City, we're going overseas with this one. We have a hot interview with my girl Sarah and John Tomeno, all the way from Australia. Video City, take it away.
John Tomeno, all the way from Australia. Welcome to Video City. How are you today?
Good, thanks. Glad to be here. Thanks for having me on.
Absolutely. I actually really love Australia. I've always wanted to visit. One of my friends lives in Gold Coast. Where do you live in Australia?
Yeah, I'm in Melbourne. So we're about a couple of hours from there, and we're not as warm and sunny as the Gold Coast, but it's a great town in Melbourne.
Oh, amazing. That sounds really cool. So how do you like living in Australia? And that's an amazing accent, by the way. I'm sure everyone is agreeing with me on that one.
Yeah, thanks. Your sounds are interesting to me too, so that's cool. Great in Australia. It's a really, really nice place. At the moment, we're in the COVID environment, so we're locked down for the next few weeks, especially in Melbourne. But it's a good chance to make some music and stay home and do some other things.
Oh, absolutely. You get to work on everything you've never gotten a chance to work on.
That's right.
Is there anything coming up in the music world that you are going to be presenting during this time?
Yeah, I've got this new video clip out for a new song called Emergency, which you'll look at today, which is great. And then I've recorded maybe another 10 songs. So I'm going to put some clips to those songs and get those visuals going and then promote those a bit so people get into the style of music I'm writing. And I'm getting into producing some other local artists as well. So I love the production side. That's where my focus is. So with this song, I wanted something that was, you know, emotional, like the song, and having an incredible video that was also really moving. If I, you know, if it works, it'll be quite a moving piece. So that was my aim for it. So there's a bit of exciting stuff coming up that people will see.
Oh, absolutely. And the video was so dope and so unique. What made you decide to get into music? How long have you been doing music for?
Well, I've been doing this really since I was, you know, a teenager, maybe before. So I started, as soon as I learned to play the guitar, I started to write songs straight away. So that's really my thing, writing songs and producing them. Then I had my own little home studio, as you may be able to see here. So I knock out some demos here, and then I go to a larger studio to get them to sound better. But I've been doing it for a long time. And with this particular song, it's about really rushing to love, not waiting for a chance, you know, to miss that opportunity. So just sort of rushing out and going for it. So the clip sort of plays on those emotional angles.
Oh, absolutely. And also, do you plan to do like any live shows or tours after this whole pandemic is over? Like, is that one of your goals, to go touring all over the world?
Well, I mean, ideally, I'm into the more behind the scenes a little bit these days with producing, but I still play out now and then acoustic shows as well, because sometimes these songs sound even better when they're just stripped down with just guitar and vocals. But I had a band going, so they're sort of on standby when things clear up around the place. But maybe some virtual shows might be good, just so people can get exposed to the movie a bit more. So yeah, that's the plan.
Soon, hopefully this pandemic will be over and then you guys will be, you know, united together and traveling and performing and doing all these amazing things that artists do. As an artist, who is your inspiration in the music world? Like, which artist do you connect with most and why?
Yeah, I like a lot of the classics, you know, the classic sort of songs from Sting through to Neil Diamond, the Beach Boys, some contemporary stuff too, of course, but really I'm inspired by those early experimental recordings a lot, and a lot of American artists. I mean, America's huge here for music, so, and I've seen a lot of your crew doing their original music on your video TV show, and it's fantastic to see some of that talent coming through. And at the moment, I've been listening to someone quite new from Atlanta. From, I'm not sure how far Atlanta is from New York, but Baby Rose, I think her name is. Have you heard of Baby
Rose?
Oh,
yeah.
Real soulful voice, a bit like, Amy Winehouse style, I think maybe. Really inspirational stuff coming from the US.
How has Australia influenced your music and your type of music?
Yeah, Australian music has been a big influence because obviously growing up, it's just all over the radio. Apart from American music, I think it's Australian music that's taught me the most. So bands like In Excess, really early on, Men at Work, Paul Kelly, lots of great Australian artists, the Angels, who else? Silverchair, Powderfinger. Hopefully these names ring a bell for you. Some of them got big overseas, some of them didn't. Right through to John Farnham. So a lot of sort of commercial pop rock was my thing. So I really emulated a lot of that music. I learnt all the songs. I played in cover bands. Midnight Oil, a lot of Midnight Oil covers as well. So some of the iconic Australian bands, I think all of them have had a big influence on my music. It was sort of a little bit less polished, a bit more sort of rugged style, pub style music. That was my thing. Because I play guitar as well, a lot of it's guitar based music, which appeals to me. Then I got into a bit more electronic music as well. But really, the Australian bands have been really, really influential, and artists. And there's also some from New Zealand, you know, Neil Finn and Tim Finn and all the rest of them. So yeah, pretty vibrant music scene, really.
I just wanted to know, if you had to collab with one artist right now, you know what, let's do it, dead or alive. If you had to collab with an artist, dead or alive, who would you collab with and why?
Well, as a guitarist, I grew up with Dire Straits, so I'd probably have to say Mark Knopfler, if he could ever dream about playing guitar with me, like an amateur compared to him. But I'd say Mark Knopfler, maybe Brian Wilson from the Beach Boys, just because of his musical ingenuity over the years. And then I reckon if I could write a song that was worthy enough, I'd get Baby Rose to sing the vocal line, because she's got a great voice and she'd add a lot of dimension to the music as well, I reckon.
Is there a goal that you have with your music? Like, what is your end goal with your music? Are you trying to inspire youth? Are you trying to send a message to people? Or what are you trying to do with your music?
Yeah, well, ultimately, I'm trying to write songs and produce them in a way that in 10 years' time, they still sound fresh, they still sound new, just by putting a lot of craft into the initial writing, just to make sure it holds up. It's not like a flavor of the month. So I think ultimately I'm trying to write songs and then have them placed and sung by other artists, you know, people with really good voices that suit the song, male and female. So I'm interested in placing those songs and having other artists on some record label roster sing my songs, and then ideally produce them as well in the studio. So in a sense, ultimately taking a bit more of a back seat and go behind the scenes a bit and do a lot more of that production side. But at the moment, to get the songs out, you really have to promote them yourself and play them yourself. So that's the initial focus. But now that I've got these video clips coming through, I think that will also help expose the music to different audiences that might have a preconception of what Australian music is like. But I'm trying to stretch those boundaries and let people see that you can sort of write in different genres and still sound really interesting. You know, I've written stuff in food, rock, electro, one hip-hop song. And I've got another hip-hop song called Guardian Angel, and I may do a clip for that soon. So I'd love to present that to you guys as well, just for something different. So I like writing in different styles.
I definitely look forward to hearing it.
Yeah, that's great. That's great. It's probably a bit more up the alley of the American scene. So that might do well there. So that's really the ultimate goal, just sort of to be remembered and to leave a bit of a legacy of, you know, high quality music, assuming I can get there. That's really the aim. Yeah.
And you will get there, and I am rooting for you all the way from New York. Is there something that you would like to say to your fan base or to your following or to anyone watching the show right now?
Well, just to say, listen out over the next few weeks, especially on YouTube, Spotify and iTunes and all those platforms. So listen out, because there will be a bunch of new songs that I've already recorded, and there'll be some nice impactful visuals for those coming out soon. So just to thank people for giving new music a listen, and I hope that's hitting home and having an effect on people when they listen and watch it. So I have an engineer producer that helps me called Peter Herron, and he's local here, and Thomas Ma is the guy who helped me put the video together. He's the animator, so he deserves a big mention, because the song's good on itself, but when you watch it with the video, it has a whole different dimension to it. So I think that's something that he brought to the table, so I've got to thank him. I'd love to take credit for it all, but it's always a bit of a team effort.
Oh, absolutely. And we're actually going to go into your video right now. It is called Emergency by John Tameno. You heard it here first. Such an amazing song. You guys are going to absolutely love it. And it's going to be available on all streams of music. And we're actually going to write down all the information on the screen right now, so you guys are going to have access to it. And we want to thank you guys all for watching. And we hope you guys are staying safe. John, thank you so much for your time. You are such a sweet person. And I really enjoyed talking to you and interviewing you.
Oh, I love talking to you, Sarah, and the team. Thanks very much again. And I hope you all enjoy the clip, and feel free to reach out at any time, send me emails or comments, and I'll write back straight away. Thanks again.
Likewise. Thank you, John.
Thank you.
I drop to the ground, I'll hardly believe I was already down. It's funny, good fortune, it favors the brave. So move yourself closer, now don't be afraid. To rush to me like it's an emergency. You must believe that it's an emergency. For all
the times you say things can wait one more day. Maybe just a moment too late, I'm afraid. This is the message it sent from above. Don't kill time waiting for love. Rush to me like it's an emergency. You must believe that it's an emergency. It's here and now that matters, you'll see. An urgency you cannot let be. I hear it now, so why don't you too? Alarm bells ring, my warning to you. Like it's an emergency. You must believe that it's an emergency. Rush to me with some that it's an emergency.
All right, Video C, thank you so much for tuning in with me, your girl Bree. Y'all know where to follow me. And stay tuned for next week. Video City, take it away.